Hey, Hyperdrive. Steven Zurita here again with Steve Cardenas again. How are you doing, Steve?
Good. This is one of my students, by the way.
Hey. And we're here at Long Beach Comic Expo. Is this your first time at Long Beach Comic?
This is my first time at the Long Beach Comic Expo, yeah.
Yeah, it's been really growing. A couple years ago, it used to be only half of this, and even before that, less. And then now it seems like it's a full-on con. Yeah. We're here in Ranger Row. There's so many of you guys. You're saying it's like a mini Morphicon now.
Yeah, it's like, yeah, a lot of LA shows are like that now. They always have like several Rangers at the show, you know, which is cool. I mean, it's great for somebody like myself because I get to get a little reunion with all my friends and stuff, so it's cool.
Yeah, and one thing I've noticed, especially in the last couple years, the Rangers all seem to hang out, and not even within, you know, your own cast, not even, you know, for you, Mighty Morphin and Zeo. It seems like you'll hang out with Time Force or Mega Force or RPM or whatever. Like, what kind of antics does the entire Ranger family get into now that everybody seems to travel together?
Well, I mean, the thing is, you know, when it comes to, you know, hanging out with all the different crews, there's a certain, like, a code, you know, not a code, I guess, but there's just, like, an order, you know. We were all part of something that, you know, not very many people in the world are a part of. So, for us, it's like we're part of a special thing. We've got this special bond. So we automatically all get along right away. I don't really know of any of Rangers that really don't get along with each other. And yeah, so it's good, you know. And me, I just, you know, I just love having fun. And when everybody gets together, we just, that energy is so amazing. So, you know, we kind of have fun and we kind of bring that with us wherever we go. So we travel all over the world doing these shows. So
yeah. It's so funny because everybody, the fans are always talking about, like, we want more reunion episodes. And even though that might not happen as much in the show, that kind of happens here at these cons because, like you're saying, everybody's traveling together, getting together around the world. It's really fun to watch. And we actually interviewed you at the last Power Morphicon in 2014. We talked all about your time on Power Rangers. And since then, very recently, actually, you released a couple photos of you in a new film. You're wearing a cop uniform going around. You want to tell us a little bit about that project?
We're working on trying to get this project made right now. It's called A Brother's Badge. And it's pretty cool. It's got some good cast in it. It's got James Russo, who was in Django Unchained. You know, so it's going to be a good show. I'm actually not going to be one of the main characters in it. I'm one of the supporting characters. And that's fun for me, actually, because I don't really want to take on the challenge of being in the lead role of something. That's a lot of work. I just kind of want to go and have fun on a movie set. So I'm in more of a different scene, but it's not going to be anything like Power Rangers at all. It's not for kids either. So anyway, just forewarning you on that. But yeah, it should be fun. So I'm going to play a cop. It's going to be fun.
Oh, yeah. You seem like, I saw the pictures and you seem to be very comfortable in the role. I don't know exactly what the scene is, but it's like you're on some sort of police mission and you seem to be really in the zone. So I was really intrigued. So I'm actually looking forward to it a lot. And speaking of movies, you were in those first two Power Rangers movies. We have this third one coming up. They're doing Mighty Morphin all over again. Do you have any words of advice to the new cast members who, I guess, by the time this comes out, we'll be in the middle of filming the new movie?
Yeah. Well, the only thing I can say is, you know, just have fun with it and remember that, you know, there's a long tradition, you know, with Power Rangers. You know, the Power Rangers has always been about unity and diversity and you know, as far as like with the different types of people that are on the earth and you know, doing good for other people, standing up for people that can't stand up for themselves, things like that. So I think that would be the message I'd pass on to them. But this is something that I think they already know, you know? Yeah. I think they already know. They grew up watching Power Rangers too, so, yeah. You know, I think they're familiar.
Yeah, that's the funny thing. Power Rangers have been around so long. I was in the Power Rangers panel yesterday, and the newer Rangers were talking about how they grew up on it. So now you have Rangers who grew up on Rangers. Yeah. There's generations of it now, which is really, really interesting to watch. And I guess from your perspective, now that, you know, conventions are really big and everybody's grown up with this show you were on, what is that like from your point of view? I mean, what do you think when you see someone walking around in a Red Ranger suit, like cosplaying as Rocky?
I think it's amazing, you know what I mean? It's like, it's a tribute, you know? It's a tribute to the work that we did, and I'm really proud of that. So it's very cool, and I'm humbled by that. And when people come up to my table and they meet me and, you know, they say something like, you were the reason I got into martial arts, or you're the reason I became this, or whatever, you know, that means something to me, you know? It's special. It's something that no one's ever going to be able to take away from me, and I was really proud to be a part of, you know?
That's such, like you said, that's got to be so humbling and amazing to hear. I that must make everything worth it.
Yeah, absolutely. And you know, and I can relate too, because you know, as a young kid myself, I was bullied, and I got introduced to the movie The Karate Kid, and I fell in love with that movie, and then I just, you know, I wanted to be like The Karate Kid, and I eventually got into martial arts, and that built my confidence up, and I was never bullied again, and you know, so I get it. So when I got to meet Ralph Macchio and I went up to him, I kind of geeked out, and I was like, dude, you're the reason I got into martial arts, you know. So you know, when people come up, I get it, you know, and I appreciate it that much more, you know. So.
So you're going to cons all over the place. Why don't we talk about where all of your fans can find you online, social media, fan clubs?
Instagram and Twitter is Steve Cardenas PR, and then my Facebook is just Steve Cardenas fan page. So look me up. I'm always posting on there all the time. Communicate with my fans that way to let people know where I'm going to be and whatnot. But I also have a new thing out now. It's called Text Rocky. It's the Team Rocky fan club. And you, what I want you to do is you text Rocky to 48421, and then I text you back, and I give you all kinds of you know, information on where I'm going to be in different cities and things like that. But not only that, each month we do a special giveaway. This month we're giving away a 50-inch flat screen TV. Next month we're going to give away a PlayStation. The next month we're going to give away an Xbox. You know, just all kinds of cool stuff. Signed Power Ranger memorabilia. Can win all kinds of cool stuff. And throughout the month as well, we also send out deals on all kinds of Team Rocky gear as well. So it's just a fun way for me to be able to communicate with the fans a little better.
Awesome. So that's the best way to keep up with Rocky, aka Steve Cardenas here. Steve, thanks so much for the interview again.
Thank you.
All right, take care.
Hey guys, thanks for watching my interview with Steve Cardenas. If you'd like to give it a thumbs up and let me know in the comments below, which season of his did you like more, Mighty Morphin or Zeo? Type that down below. And be sure to subscribe so you don't miss any of the other Power Rangers interviews or nerdy vids and laughs I upload here on Hyperdrive Picks every Thursday. Thanks for watching, and punch it!